A veritable friend in need to the busy housewife is canned chicken. A few jars of it on the storeroom shelf, which may be quickly converted into a delicious dish when unexpected company comes or when other emergencies arise, give the housekeeper a sense of preparedness. Hello there, welcome to Headlines and Voices. This is the show where we read amazing articles from publications from a century or more ago. And we had done a couple of recordings recently on trichinosis, which was basically when you eat raw pork. And it's so interesting when you're doing research like this, you start going down these paths and looking at other things. So I thought, raw pork, what about raw chicken? So I looked up anything I could find on raw chicken, and I came across this article. I haven't read the whole thing through, but I skimmed through it, and it was just interesting enough I had to do this one. This is from the Wauwatosa News in Wauwatosa, Wisconsin, from December 24th, 1920. So just barely, when I'm recording this, we're at the beginning of 2021, and so this is just barely over 100 years ago. And here's the headline. This is what grabbed me. And the main headline says, canned chicken, delicious dish. Canned chicken, delicious dish. Cheaper and easier to can surplus fowls than to feed them until wanted. So in case you have surplus fowls, in case you're the kind of person that's keeping chickens, it's maybe easier to can them than it is to just keep feeding them until you need it. So here's the article. Excellent for emergencies, by the way. Two-year-old hens are much more desirable product than six-month-old chicken. Tests made by Experimental Kitchen. A veritable friend in need to the busy housewife is canned chicken. A few jars of it on the storeroom shelf, which may be quickly converted into a delicious dish when unexpected company comes or when other emergencies arise, give the housekeeper a sense of preparedness. From an economic point of view, canning the surplus of the flock is an excellent practice, as it is cheaper to can the birds than it is to feed them until they are wanted for the table. Nor is it necessary to have young chickens for canning, for the older birds have superior flavor and quite as good texture as the younger ones. Two-year hens made a much more desirable canned product than a six-month-old chicken. The best products were obtained from plump, well-fed hens in tests recently made by the Experimental Kitchen of the United States Department of Agriculture. I wonder if something like that still exists, the Experimental Kitchen of the United States Department of Agriculture. I gotta look that up now. That's just, wow. Okay, how the canning is done. To prepare the bird for canning, it should be carefully picked and all pin feathers removed. It should be then singed and washed in water in which a small amount of baking soda has been dissolved. Remove the entrails, cut the meat into pieces as for frying, and carefully wash each piece in cold water. The giblets and excess intestinal fat should not be put into the jars. The chicken may be partially cooked before being placed in the jar, being either browned in fat or stewed. But the best results have been obtained when the uncooked chicken was packed into the jars. The jars may be filled with hot water or broth, or the meat may be canned without the addition of liquid. The best product has resulted when no liquid or only a small quantity, about 2 tablespoons to a pint jar, was added. The meat in jars to which no liquid was added has kept as well as that in jars filled with liquid and has possessed a superior flavor. The following method is therefore recommended by the Experimental Kitchen. Pack the pieces into pint jars, as much as a pound of chicken can often be packed into a pint jar. So you can get a pound of chicken into a pint jar. Two chickens weighing before dressed, a little over 4 pounds each, when cut up for canning, will fill 5 pint jars. For example, jar one may contain a thigh, leg, fillet of breast, and saddle. Jar two, a neck, wing, leg, fillet of breast, and two wishbones. Jar three, a saddle, neck, thigh, and fillet of breast. Jar four, a wing, leg, thigh, and breastbone. Jar five, a fillet of breast, thigh, two wings, and a leg. When the meat has been packed into the jar, add a half teaspoon of salt to each, partially seal, and process. If a water bath outfit is used for the processing, set the jars on a rack in the bottom of a wash boiler with sufficient water to come 2 inches above their tops. Process pint jars continuously for 6 hours after the water begins to boil. Seal the jars quickly upon removing from the boiler. Or if glass top jars fastened by a spring are used, force the spring into position while the jars are still immersed. After sealing, invert the jars to test for leaks while cooling. Reduces time of process. If a water bath outfit is used for the processing, set the jars on a rack in the bottom of a wash boiler with sufficient water to come 2 inches above their tops. Process pint jars continuously for 6 hours after the water begins to boil. Seal the jars quickly upon removing from the boiler. Or, if glass top jars fastened by a spring are used, force the spring into position while the jars are still immersed. After sealing, invert the jars to test for leaks while cooling. And there's a subheadline here that says, reduces time of process. If a steam pressure cooker is used, the length of time can be greatly reduced. 15 pounds pressure for 1 hour has been found a safe and satisfactory period. Chicken canned in either the water bath or pressure cooker is a desirable product, comparing very favorably with fresh chicken when used for chicken salad, cream chicken, chicken stew, chicken pie, or for scalloped or baked dishes. The chicken in a pint jar is sufficient to serve 6 persons when the meat is prepared in any of the ways mentioned. And that is the end of the article. So just in case you were wondering, canned chicken is a delicious dish, excellent for emergencies. Cheaper and easier to can surplus fowls than feed them until wanted. So, you know, you have all those chickens that you don't want to keep feeding because that gets pretty expensive. Keeping those chickens fed, just kill them and put them in jars, like it says here. Good solution. Anyway, if you enjoy things like this, please give this video a like. And leave comments below if there's other topics that you'd find interesting that we should be looking up. And of course, follow our channel. And just a reminder, these videos are sponsored by Audio Mover. Audio Mover is the company that takes your old audio and video tapes and converts them to digital. You can go to audiomover.com, audiomover.com, and get your order started. And if you type in headlines in checkout, you can get 15% off your order. Anyway, thanks for listening. Headlines and Voices is sponsored by Audio Mover, the company that takes your history, your old audio and video tapes, and converts them into digital. Visit audiomover.com to learn more. Headlines and Voices is a production of Thick and Mystic Media. Visit thickandmystic.com.